I've always been a people's person, and my background is social work first and then sociology. And as a sociologist, my concern has always been community development, and in particular, the development of individuals themselves. My attraction to Ann Pratt was Ann Pratt the person herself. I actually came into this organization looking for other pastures, little realizing that I had landed on the greenest of pastures, and that's how I got to be here. But in particular, the pull was Ann Pratt, the businesswoman. I looked at her, I looked at the way she operated, and my thoughts were, this is the place I want to be. And in terms of my own self promotion and ambition, if I needed to get anywhere, I thought I would need a place and a background, and in particular, the support. Because we haven't had a lot of opportunities previously to really, really get into the nitty-gritty of business. And without an MBA or a full business background, it was difficult to actually even assess where, in terms of my own personal growth as a business person, I wanted to be, and I knew I wanted to be a businesswoman. And Ann Pratt herself played a large role in my wanting to be associated with the business. And as they say, the rest is history. I actually came in at the very beginning of the company, and I think I've watched it grow. But best of all, by the time I arrived, which was 4 months after the company was launched, the broader vision was already in place. And the vision itself, which in terms of world-class operations, wanting to be the best player in Africa and in the world, as a matter of fact, and grow a business where people are actually the not only the backbone, but also a way of taking the business forward. For me, that was important, that the people were going to be playing an instrumental role in the decision-making of the company, in the shaping of the company, and above everything else, because it was a search company, in shaping other lives and the betterment of other people's lives. So those goals, but in particular world-class standards, world-class processes, world-class networks, world-class linkages, world-class business premises. I mean, operating out of premises such as Regis, when you walk in, you truly feel that you are in a world-class business, and for me that was important. Well, highlights today have been many, but my first, really, when I thought I had really, really made it, was when I made my first placement of a CEO. And this occurred after about 18 months of hard work. So being a consultant is not really easy stuff. You don't just ride into it and then things fall into place immediately. But the joy that comes with the ability to have done a good placement, which is a perfect fit, working according to proper processes, knowing that the proper research has been done, and that you have found a company fit for the company that you've been servicing, and lending not only the economic benefits for the company and for yourself, but knowing that you have actually done a good placement. That was the highlight for me. Another milestone, not only in the company, but in my life. When we went to New York, we were quite a young company at the time, and interfacing with companies that have been there for ages, companies of search that have practiced search when it was still the old boys network, and now trying to move into research, and us as a young company that was barely 2 years old, making a presentation that actually wowed everybody, and we could see in the faces of the people that we had actually touched people's lives. But for me, that was benchmarking. Mm-hmm. It said that Ann Pratt and Associates was on the right track. It told me that in terms of the things that we're putting into place, we just need to polish and not change, tweak and not overhaul. And that was important for me, to know that we've been on the right track all along. It reinforced the vision of the company. It reinforced my own vision of wanting to be part and parcel of shaping this company into a company that's going to be instrumental in the shaping of the South African economy as a whole. So New York was important. Well, I guess the opening sentence to answer that would be pushing the envelope. I've been in this company, and pushing the envelope has been an instrumental phrase. And I come back with a lot of mixed feelings, but above everything else, excitement. I'm looking forward to things that are going to be unfolding, and I know there's going to be a lot. And within this company, in any one given day, it's almost like 50 years unfolding all at the same time. So I'm looking forward to that. I'm also very confident that with the mentorship that I've enjoyed hitherto from Anne, you know, that is actually going to support me all the way. Am I afraid of taking on the MD challenge? Not in terms of the support that I know will be around me. And when I say support, I'm talking about 24-hour support. And it is going to be a lot of hard work. It's going to be a lot of running. It's going to be a lot of effort. But in terms of all the values and the systems and processes that are there in place to see me through, I wouldn't say piece of cake, but I'd say quite enjoyable. I welcome the challenge, and I'm looking forward to thinking very seriously about doing it and doing it.